Welcome to Real Reviews. This week, we saw the only movie we were forced to watch. Angel Has Fallen.
Yeah, I have not seen the first two.
I saw the first one and I hated it.
So, yeah, well, you know, oh man. These movies feel like they were made for like the late 80s, early 90s. They feel very generic. It's a very generic action movie. So generic, in fact. Kurt looked at me, said, "I bet you this is the reason why this guy does this." And then I say, "I bet you this is the guy that's pulling the strings for this guy." So we had guessed the movie in the first 15 minutes.
15? I don't even think that was even 15.
And then we just laughed because it was so poorly done. Like, the action's good. Yeah. There's good actors in it. You have Gerard Butler.
Yeah.
You have Morgan Freeman.
Morgan Freeman.
That's the president. You have old Piper Perabo in there.
Yeah.
Like, these are good actors. Nick Nolte, he's too old to be acting now. Let's be serious. It's good action, but the script is just so generic and so plain that for us to have guessed the movie in the first 10, 15 minutes, there's nothing there.
Laziness. There's nothing I hate more in a movie than laziness. And that's all this screenplay was lazy. Anybody, like, nobody should be able to do that. And the worst thing, the biggest offense of this movie is they played it off like there's some geniuses behind this screenplay. Like,
I hate that the
we're
going
to pull the wool over their eyes.
Like, I know, and there's no wool.
There's no wool at all. Like, I was just, and it. There's so many contradictions.
Oh,
like the bad guy's
much.
Motive.
Yeah.
One second he's like, "I do this for the game, man, for the adrenaline rush."
Yeah.
20 minutes later he's like, "I don't spend $10 million, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
I want my money." It's like, well, what's your motivation?
In the first speech he's like,
I don't do this for the money.
I do it for the action. And then he's complaining about money.
It's just laziness like that. And the whole base of this story is that this group that is pulling off trying to kill the president or whatever is smarter and has more gadgets and technology to outsmart the U.S.
Yeah,
government.
Right.
Even though at the beginning of the movie, they're almost bankrupt.
Yeah. So it takes place, there's they're talking about getting more contractors overseas to fight in the war. So obviously you see right away where this is going. There's a contractor, you know, Jerry Butts' character, he's in line to be the next head of the
Secret Service.
So his friend approaches him, "Hey, do me a solid, maybe throw my name in the hat." "Yeah, okay." You already see where this is going.
Yeah.
So it's so ridiculous though, because they frame Jerry Butts' character in the movie. And so they bring in the FBI, and the FBI is so poor at their job in this movie.
I know.
I'm like, really? Like, it is clearly a blatant setup, but the FBI are sure it's Jerry Butts. And I'm just like, no FBI agent or head of their division would be doing this.
I don't even care ridiculous. If I say spoilers in this, because the movie's too bad for even you to go see. Yeah, I know, it's just stupid things. Like, he's on his way, Gerard Butler's character's on his way to jail. These guys come and, like, take him away to, like, make it look like a setup, but his character ends up killing those guys.
Yeah.
So you got two sets of dead people, but they're like, I think it's still him.
Yeah.
It's like, it's not still him. At one point, he literally wrote on the wall who it is,
right.
And the FBI is like, there's only one person can do that. And he's like, I know who it is. It's the guy that was just written on the wall, but he's sitting there thinking about it. Just like, and the point, the president's in a coma. He's not even dead.
Right.
It's like, the whole movie is pointless because the president's not even dead to begin with. He can wake up and be like, "Well, no, that's not how that went."
Yeah.
But he'll say it cool like Morgan Freeman's like, "I don't think that is how that went." Something. That's more, I don't know what that
like
is.
Like, I feel that this is a movie that my dad would enjoy. It's a movie
old
that,
Cam?
Old Cam Gruber. You know, this is a movie where it's just like, yeah, guns and action explosions. Doesn't care about the story at all because it's so poorly written, and me and him argue a lot about this kind of movie. Oh, did you watch that one? No, it's horrible.
See, I don't even, you said earlier, like, to the 80s and 90s, I will take, you know, an over-the-top crazy action as long as it's fun. This can have crazy good action, but I can't stand watching just, this is like, lazy horror movie writing, yeah, you know? Yeah. This is just lazy action movie writing. You don't get a pass just because you blow some stuff up.
And because you got Jerry Butts and Morgan Freeman?
Yeah, I don't care. For that fact alone, this one's getting a 2. Stupid movie.
Yeah, I don't think I'll be visiting the first two. I don't think you need to watch the first two to watch this one, if anybody's wondering, if anybody cares.
I don't think you need to watch any of them.
Right. This is definitely something that you wait until it's free. Netflix. It'll be on Netflix in 4 weeks. Just wait till then. I'll give it yeah, sure, 2. I don't care.
Go check out our Facebook page. Give it a like, and you can find out how you can get entered to win $30 to Perkins Restaurant and Bakery. And you can go to Perkins every week and check out their new menu items. And we'll wash the taste out of our mouth of this past week in Wolf, because this weekend is It Chapter 2.
Ooh.